5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
When I had come down this hill, I had seen this creature cross the road. It would have ripped my locked door from my truck, extracted me from my vehicle, and there wouldn't have been a damn thing I could have done about it.
This thing, I got to notice its eyes. Its eyes was real, real evil, real sinister looking. You know, the look it was giving me.
Hello?
Get somebody out here.
What's going on now, sir?
That son of a bitch is about 6'9", I don't know.
Do you see him now, sir?
Yes, I'm looking right at him.
Uh-oh.
Welcome to Sasquatch Chronicles, a place where people share their encounters. Let's start the show. Welcome to the show, everyone. Thanks for being here tonight. You know, I really do appreciate you guys very much. I know I say I appreciate too much, and everyone hates it when I say that, but I really do appreciate you guys so much. It's been a rough week for me. Moved into a different place. I'm still in the process of actually setting up my new studio. So I have half of my equipment still in one place, trying to set it up in another place. And it's been somewhat of a nightmare. Imagine trying to move all of your stuff through a normal move and then trying to move all of your equipment too as well and getting everything set up. So I appreciate you guys being here tonight. Thank you guys so much for being patient with me this week. I know normally I do a show on Friday night, and there's just no way I could have gotten it out Friday night. I just, there was just no way. I didn't even have internet set up at the new place yet. So I kind of had to do in between trying to set things up. And anyway, it's been somewhat of a nightmare. I'm sure no one cares. You know, one thing about life, I'll say, instead of complaining to you guys, because I know that's not why you're here. You know, life is a funny thing. When life beats you down and they say you're supposed to enjoy life, but, you know, life kind of feels like a boxing ring at times, doesn't it? Doesn't it feel like sometimes life, you're in the ring with Mike Tyson and he's just beating the crap out of you and you just keep getting up and keep getting up. And but that's what you got to do. Got to keep getting up, got to keep doing it. And I just want to say I really, really do appreciate you guys being here. Sunday's still up in the air at this point. I'm still trying to set up my studio. The show sounds a little bit different tonight. It's because I kind of have a thing Jimmy rigged up at this point, doing the show. The good news is I got a great studio that I'm going to be working from. Got a lot of things coming down the pipeline as far as content goes. I put off the conspiracy corner shows. I know either people hate them or they love them, and there's really no in between. And I'm working on a Bigfoot-related conspiracy show. I think you guys might be interested in it. Duke will be there, and I plan on having a few special guests come in to talk about some things, so some recent things that happened. So very interesting things coming down the pipeline. Remember, if you've had an encounter and you'd like to be on the show, shoot me an email. My email address is wes@sasquatchchronicles.com. And I got a lot of good things coming. So thank you guys so much again for being patient with me. I was reading through the comments that I posted the other week and about in the process of moving. And I just appreciate all your guys' positive comments. It does mean a lot to me. I actually do go through and read the comments. I know a lot of people think I don't, but I actually do go through and read the comments. So thank you so much to you guys for just bearing with me this week. Let's jump into it tonight. Matt. Welcome to the show. Thank you for being here tonight.
Yeah, no problem, Wes.
And if you would, I know you had a couple encounters. If you would, kind of start from the beginning. Tell us what you were out doing and what you ran into and what you experienced.
Yes, sir. It was around October or November 2012. And me and my girlfriend, we were out mudding or trail riding in the Ocala National Forest. We do that a lot. We live in a Umatilla. It's a small town in Florida. I don't know if y'all know where Ocala is, but it's in like the middle of Florida. Anyways, we were out riding, and we came upon like a mud hole, and my girlfriend told me to go around it, but that kind of made me want to go through it even more. So I went through it and got stuck and was buried, couldn't get out. So we sat there for like a couple hours. Nobody came. We didn't have service at the time. So I was out there, and I heard a knocking on a tree, and I thought, you know, it might have been somebody like nailing up a tree stand or something. So I walked towards it, and when I got to it, opened up into like a little clearing with like some saplings and some pine trees and stuff, and there was like a half-dead pine tree, and I seen a dude with a stick hitting on a tree, and I thought it was a guy like in camo or a ghillie suit, but he was really big though, so I was like, man, that's a big dude. But then once I got a little closer, I seen it wasn't a dude at all. And I was like, oh, man. I didn't know what it was. You know, like I almost thought it was like a bear. But then I was like, you know, bear can't hit a tree with a stick. So I got real nervous. And I started to back away real slowly. And then it turned and looked at me. And I can't even describe to you how, like what I felt. Like, it was like, you ever had like a dream? And it's like something scares you and you can't move. You know what I'm saying? You try to move, but you can't move. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah,
like, I don't know
absolutely.
If you've ever had a dream like that, but you get so scared you couldn't move. So I was kind of stuck there for it. Yeah, I was kind of stuck there for a minute. But he watched me for a minute and then he just took off. But the way he took off was it was like a run, but it was almost like a glide. Like he barely, it almost like he didn't even touch the ground with his feet. He just, I don't know, he just moved through the forest like it, you know, like if me or you tried to run through the woods, we have to, you know, jump over stuff and it, you know, clumsily, but he was, you know, graceful with it. So, but the face on him looked like, have you ever seen like Planet of the Apes,
yeah.
The new one?
Yeah, you know, absolutely.
It kind of looked like a cross between that, but it was, you know, more human looking, but the expression is what, like, scared me the most, because the look he was looking at me, it was like he was, I don't know if I want to say contemplating something, like he was weighing his options on what to do, but I didn't really like what he was looking, you know. So, but luckily he just ran off. He was like the color of him, he was like a brownish red, not red, but when the sun would hit him, when he ran off, the sun hit him, so he was kind of reddish, brownish, in different parts. Around his chest, he had less hair. His legs, his calves and stuff had less hair. His arms were really long. Like, his arms were, and they were, like, muscular all the way through. But they didn't have much hair either. The face kind of had hair, but not, you know, it was like a shorter hair, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, it wasn't like a big bushy hair or nothing like that. And the nose was, it protruded a little bit. But you could see like the nostrils almost like a gorilla. You know what I'm saying? Like, it wasn't like ours, you know, you can't really see our nostrils. It's like, but his, you could see it. But he ran away and I went back to the car with my kids and my girlfriend were there. So all I had only at the time was like a little 380. So I went and locked the doors and they thought I was crazy because I told them, you know, and they're like, they thought I was, like, joking with them, but then my little kids, they started getting scared, so I was like, no, it'll be okay. But, yeah, I'm like, I'm kind of getting goosebumps now telling the story. But, yeah, I locked the doors, and we stayed in the car, and the battery was dead, too, by that time, too, so it was hot. So we just stayed in that car for, like, 2 hours until somebody came and towed us out, and I didn't even tell them, you know, the people that towed us out. And the second instance was we run dogs for deer. I don't know if y'all even are allowed to do that or not up in Washington, or how you hunt or whatnot up there. But down here, we let dogs go, and they run deer, and they, you can either, you know, they chase them back towards you, and you like go in front of them and stuff like that and wait for the deer.